This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. In phonetics, vowel reduction is any of various changes in the acoustic quality of vowels, which are related to changes in stress, sonority, duration, loudness, articulation, or position in the word, e.g. for Creek language, and which are perceived as weakening. It most often makes the vowels shorter as well. Such a vowel may be called reduced or weak. An unreduced vowel may be contrasted as full or strong. Contents: 1. Weakening of vowel articulation. 2. Vowel inventory reduction. 3. Specific languages: 31. English. 32. Bulgarian. 33. Russian. 34. Early Slavic languages. 35. Latin. 4. See also. 5. References. 6. Bibliography. Weakening of vowel articulation. Phonetic reduction most often involves a centralization of the vowel, that is, a reduction in the amount of movement of the tongue in pronouncing the vowel, as with the characteristic change of many unstressed vowels at the ends of English words to something approaching schwa. A well-researched type of reduction is that of the neutralization of acoustic distinctions in unstressed vowels, which occurs in many languages. The most common reduced vowel is schwa, whereas full vowels are distinguished by height, backness, and roundness. According to Bollinger, 1986, reduced unstressed vowels are largely unconcerned with height or roundness. English, for example, may range phonetically from mid to de open. English ranges from close to open mid. The primary distinction is that is further front than, contrasted in the numerous English words ending in unstressed ia, that is, the jaw, which to a large extent controls vowel height, tends to be relaxed when pronouncing reduced vowels. Similarly, English ranges through and, although it may be labialized to varying degrees, the lips are relaxed in comparison to u, o, or. The primary distinction in words like folio is again one of backness. However, the backness distinction is not as great as that of full vowels. Reduced vowels are also centralized, and are sometimes referred to by that term. They may also be called obscure, as there is no one-to-one correspondence between full and reduced vowels. Sound duration is a common factor in reduction. In fast speech, vowels are reduced due to physical limitations of the articulatory organs, e.g., the tongue cannot move to a prototypical position fast or completely enough to produce a full quality vowel. Compare with clipping. Different languages have different types of vowel reduction, and this is one of the difficulties in language acquisition. See, e.g., non-native pronunciations of English and Anglophone pronunciation of foreign languages. Vowel reduction of second language speakers is a separate study. Stress-related vowel reduction is a principal factor in the development of Indo-European oblaut, as well as other changes reconstructed by historical linguistics. There are several ways to distinguish full and reduced vowels in transcription. Some English dictionaries mark full vowels for secondary stress, so that e.g. is a full unstressed, while as a reduced unstressed schwa. The vowel quality may be considered distinct, with reduced vowels centralized, e.g. with full versus reduced. Some transcriptions of English and Russian use non-IPA letters for reduced vowels, such as an in English or an for unstressed, I, and in Russian. Such vowel reduction is one of the sources of distinction between a spoken language and its written counterpart. Vernacular and formal speech often have different levels of vowel reduction, and so the term vowel reduction is also applied to differences in a language. Variety with respect to, e.g., the language standard. Some languages, such as Finnish, Hindi, and Classical Spanish, are claimed to lack vowel reduction. Such languages are often called syllable-timed languages. At the other end of the spectrum, Mexican Spanish is characterized by the reduction or loss of the unstressed vowels, mainly when they are in contact with the sound s. It can be the case that the words pesos, pesers, and paces are pronounced the same. Vowel inventory reduction. In some cases, phonetic vowel reduction may contribute to phonemic phonological reduction, which means merger of phonemes, induced by indistinguishable pronunciation. This sense of vowel reduction may occur by means other than vowel centralization. However, many Germanic languages, in their early stages, reduced the number of vowels that could occur in unstressed syllables, without or before clearly showing centralization. Proto-Germanic and its early descendant Gothic still allowed more or less the full complement of vowels and diphthongs to appear in unstressed syllables, except notably short e, which merged with I. In early Old High German and Old Saxon, this had been reduced to five vowels I, E, A, O, U, some with length distinction, later reduced further to just three short vowels I, E, A, O, U in Old Norse. Likewise, only three vowels were written in unstressed syllables, A, I and U. Their exact phonetic quality is unknown. Old English, meanwhile, distinguished only E, A, and U or O. Catalan, a Romance language, also shows reduction, but in differing degrees depending on dialect. The Valencian dialect reduces the number of possible vowels from 7 to 5 in unstressed environments, merging into and into the central Catalan dialect goes even further, distinguishing only, and or, within becoming and merging into in Italian. The vowels noted E and O in spelling are pronounced and in unstressed syllables specific languages English main article, reduced vowels in English. This section needs expansion. You can help by adding to it December 2012 Bulgarian. In the Bulgarian language the vowels A, O and E can be reduced when unstressed to U and I, respectively the most prevalent is A. There are five vowel phonemes in standard Russian. Vowels tend to merge when they are unstressed. The vowels A, and O, have the same unstressed allophones for a number of dialects and reduced to an unclear schwa. Unstressed E may become more central if it does not merge with I. Other types of reduction are phonetic, such as that of high vowels, I, and U, which become near close so atap stage is pronounced, and muschina man is pronounced. Early Slavic languages main article, Havlik's Law. The Proto-Slavic language possessed two short high vowel vowels known as yers, a short high front vowel denoted as I or, and a short back vowel denoted as U or. These vowels underwent reduction and were eventually deleted in certain positions in a word. The early Slavic languages, beginning from the late dialects of Proto-Slavic, this process is known as Havlik's Law. Latin. For more details on this topic, see History of Latin section. Most cases they reduced to I, before L pinguis, and L, not followed by IIL, they became Old Latin, O, and Classical Latin, U, before R, and some consonant clusters, they became E, facio, ad facio. Unstressed vowel references caret acoustic vowel reduction in Creek, effects of distinctive length and position in the word PDF caret Bollinger 1986, p. Timing syllable more a metrical foot vowel reduction tone tone contour pitch accent register downstep upstep downdrift tone terracing floating tone tone sandy tone letter stress secondary stress. Vowel reduction accent length chrome gemination vowel length extra short prosody intonation pitch pitch contour pitch reset stress rhythm loudness prosodic unit pausa.